Hey everybody, thank you for listening to Eleanor's Elite Radio. Today's a great day. We have Sheriff Wayne Ivey with us. How are you today, Mr. Ivey?
I'm doing great. Thank you for having me today.
Thank you so much. I'm not going to keep you long today because I know how busy you are. I mean, like every day of the week, you have always something happening and going on. I wanted to first ask just something a little bit more personal this time. How about a project or an accomplishment that you consider to be the most significant in your career? Have you had a moment like that, a project that you've worked on?
Yeah, you know, I've been blessed in my 39 years, Eleanor, to have a number of different things that have happened along the way that really have a legacy of impacting our citizens in a very positive way. And I would say one of those is when I was with the Florida Department of Law Enforcement, I created the very first in the country child abduction response team. And we call them the CART, Child Abduction Response Team. And that program happened, the creation of it was right after Jessica Lunsford was kidnapped and murdered. And it was really, the concept was less, I'm sorry, I take it back. It was not Jessica Lunsford, it was Carla Brucia.
Right.
When she was abducted and murdered. And, you know, the concept of the program was we're waiting for the emergency to happen. We have something like this happen. Then we try and bring all of our resources together. So what we did with CART was we identified our resources. We pre-trained, we pre-staged everything so that when the emergency happened, we could immediately go into action. And what started as something we were doing in the Orlando region is now considered the model for investigating child abductions throughout the country.
Wonderful.
And, you know, it was ultimately used in a lot of the abductions as just countless rescue stories where the child was saved. And, you know, I look back and I thought we were looking at it just from a regional perspective, and it grew into a absolute model program that will, you know, forever help save children's lives. So that would be one of them. And then, you know, from a completely different perspective, what our team has been able to do in saving the lives of homeless pets here in Brevard County.
Yes, sir.
You know, that is one of those things that one day I'll look back and say, I was just blessed and thankful to be a part of.
Is there any, do you have any events coming up with the Brevard County Sheriff Office, the Animal Services Department, anything coming up recently that we can let my listeners know about?
You know, we constantly do, and the best thing to do is go to our webpage, brevardsheriff.com. And we always post adoption events and specials that we're doing around the community. And, you know, we're, the level of success we had in animal services and becoming a no-kill facility really is a testament of the employees and volunteers that are there, the partnership we've developed with our citizens, and the partnership we've developed with our local rescues around you know, the community, the SPCA, Humane Society, Friends for Animal Sanctuary, Feline Network, PERS. I can go on and on about
the
partners and rescues we have. And
because
when you look at the success, it's an immediate result of those partnerships.
And you're absolutely correct. And a lot of agencies, Mr. Ivey, make it very difficult for people to adopt. You know, I understand protecting animals because I'm an animal. I'm a child and animal activist in that order. And I feel that, you know, what you have done for the no-kill shelter and what you've done, you know, is phenomenal. But a lot of other adoption agencies make it very difficult with the prices that they charge, you know, the meet and greets that you have to follow through. It's just, there's so many steps, and sometimes they have a little bit of an attitude too. And I understand that attitude is to protect the animal, but at the same time, you want to find a home for that animal. Don't make it so difficult.
You know, Our team does a really good job at trying to vet those that are going to adopt the pets. And there's also a flip side to that. We're vetting the pet, too, to make sure that it's a good fit, because that's the most important part, is to have that good fit there. To the adoption fees, we're pretty blessed. We have a number of great financial supporters. AJ Hires, for example, of Boniface Hires is a perfect example. AJ, during the month of December, all adoptions are on him. He pays for all the adoptions, everything that goes along with that adoption. We have some other, organizations that help us in all different aspects. But again, Eleanor, that goes back to that. I tell everybody, and I encourage everybody to become shipbuilders. By shipbuilders, what I mean is build partnerships, build relationships, build friendships, because they're going to solve problems for us a lot better than anything else. And so it really comes down to doing that.
Absolutely. I agree 100%. I put the picture of you and that, I think it's a bloodhound. Is that a bloodhound?
It is. That's Judy.
Is that your dog or no?
Well, yes and no. Judy works for the sheriff's office, but if you ask anybody, Judy is the sheriff's dog. He is with me a lot. In fact, he's with me more often than he's not now. I pick him up in the mornings, and he stays at our Paws and Stripes College, but his bed is in the back seat of my truck right now, because I pick him up all the time. He is Junie is named after a little boy who in 1991 unfortunately was abducted and murdered
from Cocoa Beach. I remember.
Yes. And Junie's named after him. And actually, when we swore Junie in, Junie's Rios's mom actually came and pinned his badge on him.
Wow.
And it's really unique. Junie, we're using to track missing children, to track those that may have Alzheimer's or dementia. But more than anything, we use Junie now in crime prevention and community relations. And he has a very special way with children. He will let 300 kids come up to him and pet him and love on him and everything else. And so
that's
wonderful. He knows what his purpose in this world is. He absolutely does. And he is with me a lot. We actually are just transforming. We've always, our mascot in the sheriff's office has always been Deputy Courage, a big inflatable suit. it has seen much better days. It's a suit now. It's not an inflatable suit anymore, because it doesn't work. But we decided that it was a good opportunity, so we have transitioned now. The Brevard County Sheriff's Office mascot is a big bloodhound, called Junie. It's called Junie the Sheriff's Bloodhound, and we have bloodhound suit and everything. So
I want to touch base on something you mentioned a little bit earlier about the human trafficking and missing children. I know that, for a little while there, all of social media had, rating Merritt Island compared to Melbourne and Palm Bay, cases of human trafficking. I don't want to get into particulars on that. And I know a lot of that stuff is very confidential. But what can we as citizens do to be helpful?
Well, it applies in the aspect of human trafficking and child abduction. The same advice applies in what we always tell our citizens about everything else, and that is, if you see something, say something.
Right.
And by that, when you consider that our citizens are 600,000 plus, they're out everywhere. They're at schools. They're at shopping malls. They're at movie theaters. They're at church. They're at appointments. They're at hair salons. They're at nail parlors. They're at hotels. Everywhere else. What we encourage people to do is to know the signs of a victim of human trafficking. You can actually, if you just go and Google search, what are the signs of human trafficking? It'll give you a very comprehensive list.
Wow, that's wonderful.
And so what we ask is for our citizens, if they see something that makes that hair stand up on the back of their neck, give us a call.
Right.
Let us get checked out. The worst that happens is that you're wrong and everybody's safe.
Right.
That's the absolute. We get to meet you. We get to meet them. It's a positive if nobody's been harmed.
Absolutely.
Best that happens is if you're right, we have a chance to save somebody's life. And so don't hesitate. If you see something, say something to us. You know, if you go back and look at some of the worst horrific incidents that have happened in our country, I'll use 9/11, for example. When they went back and started putting the pieces of that puzzle together, and they were interviewing neighbors and teachers and everything, everyone said, I thought something was wrong.
Right.
But I didn't want to say anything because I might offend somebody. Well, we as a country have to get past that. We have to start thinking that somebody could be in harm, and by saying something, we save their life.
Exactly. And you know, Mr. Ivey, this is not the first time you've ever made almost national news with your wheel of, not Wheel of Fortune.
Wheel of Fugitive.
Wheel of Fugitive. I mean, you were on national TV, radio, TV stations all over the world. A lot of people loved it. Like, I know all of Florida loved it. A lot of states did not. But did you ever think possibly maybe about running for office, since you, everybody just so adores everything that you do for the community, for citizens, for children and animals? Did you ever think about running for political office of any kind?
You mean before I ran for sheriff? No, I you know, before I ran for sheriff, I never thought about running for office. But now that I've been elected sheriff, this is all I want to do. You know, I get asked a lot of times, would I consider running for governor? Would I
yes.
run for Congress? And the answer is no.
Wow.
I've been a cop my entire adult life, and I am great with that. There is nothing else I would have ever wanted to do in my life but be a cop. And I want to, whenever the day comes, and I hope it won't be soon, I hope the citizens will let me continue to serve. But whenever the day does come when I'm no longer sheriff, that'll be it for me. My wife and I are going to sit back at that point and enjoy our lives.
I don't blame you. You really have done a lot for everybody. And you know what? I kind of understand that. I understand the fact that you would like to be in, you know, to remain to be sheriff so you can continue to help. You know, when you become a politician, it changes so much of your life and everything. It's something.
Well, you know, my dad used to tell me when I was a little boy growing up that as much as I like to talk, I was either going to be a preacher, a politician, or a policeman. And, sometimes I get to do all three, you know. And so, but I just recently, in fact, there was a Facebook post we did. You know, I was blessed and humbled to be offered. The governor offered me to serve at some point as the commissioner of FDLE.
Right.
And I turned that down. Because I love doing what I'm doing. And,
right.
You know, he's deceased now, but there was a basketball coach that, served as a mentor to me, and he doesn't know that. I just followed his career and I've studied, everything he said, but, it's a guy by the name of Jim Valvano, who was basketball coach at NC State for many years.
Mm-hmm.
And I heard Jim Valvano say one time that to be successful, you have to remember three things: where you're from, where you are, and where you want to be. And if where you are is where you want to be, you're the most successful person around.
Wow.
And I am where I want to be. I am.
You're where you want to be.
Where I am is exactly where I want to be.
That's wonderful. And that's wonderful because that means you're happy in what you're doing. You're very successful.
Oh, I love it.
And it shows. It shows how happy you are. You know,
I wake up every morning. I can't wait to put this uniform on. I get to wear the same uniform as the men and women heroes of the Brevard County Sheriff's Office. They're the ones that are out there every day, putting their lives on the line, responding to calls and car crashes and, you know, all the different things that they do that puts their lives in harm's way. I get to wear the same uniform they do. So, I get to do it every day, and I wake up and can't wait to do it. So.
Now, I know you're a role model for a lot of young people in our community, but who's your role model?
Oh, man, it's funny. I teach some leadership classes, and I always talk about who my role models and my mentors are. And, I have three of them. One of them, was my father, who I lost in 1997 to cancer. My dad taught me to have a sense of humor. My dad taught me to have character and honor and respect. And, so, you know, a big part of who I am is who he was.
Yes.
Jim Balvano was the second one.